Good morning, good afternoon, or good night, or whatever time it may be in your part of the world. My name is Mr. John Wayne, and I am a variety gamer. I play everything from the Fallout franchise all the way to the Soulsborne series. Welcome, everybody, to another episode of my Dark Souls Remastered walkthrough. I hope everybody's doing well. I know that I am. In today's episode, we're going to go beat the Bell Gargoyles. But before we do that, we're going to go buy some stuff from the merchant using our souls. We got a little over 100,000 souls. Got a little carried away with it. But you don't have to do that. You can get less souls if you'd like. I just got a few extra to be able to level up with and get all the items that we need. We also have 10 humanity from doing the soul farm. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get started here. Kill these hollows. Get a short sword. Ooh. Let's go ahead and get the attention of this guy here. Wait for him to walk his happy butt over here. They're pretty slow, but they're easy to parry, so it's give or take. Nice, we got a Titanite shard. We can use as many as we can get. Also, real quick, I'm going to go into my inventory. I did get some extra Titanite shards as well. We have about 8. Well, we had 7. I collected 7 by doing that soul farm. Every now and then, a hollow would fly in kind of my direction, and I would loot them if they had any loot. Some of them had some Titanite shards, so you may have more, you may have less. Thought I was gonna get smacked in the face again there. Being pretty brave by not healing. Got a battle axe. That's not a bad weapon if you're into axes. Let's go ahead and talk to the merchant.
Oh, there you are. Still keeping your marbles all together? Then go ahead, don't be a nitwit. Never hurts to splurge when your days are numbered.
We're going to go ahead and purchase a dried finger. Dried finger allows you to summon in an extra co-oper, but you'll also have a greater chance of being invaded as well. So it's a give or take with that one. And then the orange guidance stone or soapstone allows you to write messages on the ground for other players. Online, all of this, by the way. Let's go ahead and grab the repair box, the bottomless box, and then we need a short bow. And we're going to buy 200 standard arrows. Oop, went a little too far there. There we go. Let's go ahead and talk to the merchant a little bit.
Oh, this one. Ain't she lovely? Her name is Yulia. She's plumb in love with me. You'd never leave my side now, would you, Yulia? Oh, you can forget it. I'm all that she needs. Careful! She'll bite your little fingers off. Be kind, Yulia, be kind! Now, don't squander your time chatting. You need to look over my wares. Oh, thank you very much. Come back soon.
And that's all he has to say. You can kill this merchant, by the way, and get a Uchi Katana. It's up to you if you want to do that. I'm not going to do it. No need to kill him. Let's go over to the bonfire and level up. We're going to put vitality all the way at 20. Our attunement, we're going to go up to 10. That way we can get one attunement slot. That's going to come in handy a little later. Not in this episode. Then we're going to put endurance at 20. Strength at 19. Dex at 19. And that's all we can do for now. We'll be at level 35. Before we go any further, let's go ahead and equip our short bow. And then we will equip some standard arrows. And climb this ladder. We're going to go through this doorway. Right here, we're going to press triangle to two-hand our bow. And then we want to aim just above this, it looks like rooftop, where there's like a couple of bricks. We want to aim just a little bit above that. Wait for the dragon tail to get in our way. And then we're going to shoot it. So this is going to take a while. It's probably going to take about 30 to 40 arrows to get his tail to be cut off so we can get the Drake sword. I'll see everybody here in just a minute when we actually get the Drake sword. All right, and we are back. We got the Drake sword, finally. It only took us, I don't want to say 30, well, maybe 30 arrows. Didn't take us too long. Let's go ahead and switch back to our sword. We're going to come over here. Take care of this hollow right here. We have another spear guy. It's up to you if you feel comfortable fighting him on this narrow path here, or if you would like to lure him out into a wider area like over here or something. That's up to you. Over here, through that doorway, is three rats. Not really going to mess with them because they do have poison buildup and there's no sense to go over there. Let's run over here. Dragon's going to breathe fire, kill all those enemies. We're just going to wait here until the dragon jumps down. As soon as it jumps down, we're going to make a run for it. Go. Keep running. He's probably gonna get us with some fire. Just keep running. Do not stop. If he catches you with the fire, just make it over here and you'll be safe. Hellkite is gonna fly off into the distance or into the sunset, whichever you would prefer. We can kill these hollows here. They only give us 24 souls, but like I said at the very beginning of the walkthrough, every soul matters. Grab ourselves the soul of a nameless soldier, and then we pick up the claymore. My favorite weapon in the game. You don't have to use this weapon, but I'm gonna use it. I'm gonna use it for this playthrough. We can take off the gold pine resin. We're not going to be using that anytime soon. We can two-hand our sword now. Let's go ahead and light this bonfire and then we're going to sit at it and kindle it. We have plenty of humanity to kindle this bonfire. Don't be scared to use it if you have a lot. Let's open up this gate. Take care of that hollow. Right here, if you go down that ladder, that's where those rats are. that I said I wasn't going to deal with. Going up here may cause a lot of player deaths. And it's completely up to you if you want to mess with this Black Knight. I'm going to. I can't guarantee you I will survive. But I'm going to lure him down here. Or try to, at least. He can be a little glitchy sometimes. Sometimes he can kill himself. Like walk off a ledge or fall through the world. If you're lucky. If not, just try to keep his attention. Bring him down here. Sorry if everybody's getting dizzy from the spiral staircase. Did he turn around? I think he did. That's what's really annoying about this Black Knight. He'll turn around and he will de-aggro. I hate this Black Knight. There he goes. Come on, bud. You have to, like, literally slowly walk him down here. I'm escorting you to your doom. Or my own doom. I don't know. Stay by the bonfire if you can. We're going to try to parry this guy to death. We'll see how it works. Obviously not very well. There we go. Get another parry. All we need is one more parry. Let's go ahead and heal ourselves. Just in case. Get him to run over here. This guy hurts quite a bit. So just be very careful with him. He's still got just a little bit of health. I'm going to smack him. And he's going to give us the Black Knight Greatsword. That is not a guaranteed drop. It's a pretty rare drop. I think because we have a bunch of humanity and we're in our human form, we're able to get that as a drop. Real quick, item discovery is tied to your humanity. You can get up to 10 humanity, and that will give you the most item discovery you can get for now until we get the gold covetous serpent ring. And also being in your human form will give you better item discovery as well. Let's just sit at this bonfire really quick. He also gave us a Titanite chunk as well, so there's that as well. We want to dash up these stairs. Do not slow down. Just keep running, jump, and we want to get in front of this gate because this guy right here is going to close it on us. Be very careful. Do not go all the way up these stairs or you're going to be fighting another enemy that you really don't want to fight right now while you're trying to fight all these hollows at the same time. See if we can't get this guy to try to hit us. Ah! Guy had some good timing there. With the arrow, that is. Take that guy out. Now we have to go ahead and heal ourselves. We'll get the basement key. We won't need that just yet. That won't be for another few episodes. We want to run right past this boar. lure him down here. Be careful not to get hit by his tusks there. Can hurt. Pretty bad. You can backstab him, which is nice. Go. He didn't drop it, but every now and then you can get lucky and get him to drop a boar helm. It's a pretty sweet helmet. Looks really cool. Get a backstab on this archer. Get him out of the way. Grab some alluring skulls. You can use those on beast type enemies, and when you throw them, they'll run to that destination and be distracted by the alluring skull. Hence the name alluring skull. I'm gonna come down here. We have an ambush. He's gonna run up there. While he does that, two hollows are gonna try to attack us, but that's all right. We knew about the ambush, so we did not get got. Just be really careful. These hollows can be dangerous. I know they don't seem dangerous, but they have a frenzy attack that they can use and really mess you up. The ones that are worse than these hollows are the torch hollows. Those guys can kill you really easily. Get the mystery key. We'll be using that shortly to let an NPC out of prison or captivity. Oh, I thought I was gonna get that. Go ahead and pick up that item on the beam. And then when we're up here, we're just going to go through this fog wall. And if we look down, that's where we were at earlier. Let's go ahead and heal ourselves real quick. We'll sneak up behind this knight and completely biff the backstab. Grab that knight shield. Usually you can backstab that guy and get an instant kill. Over here we should have a spear guy. He's trying to stab me right off the rip. It's all right, I was prepared. So over here, you want to be very careful. Off to the right side, you're going to have a spear guy, and then off to the left, you're going to have a knight. So what I like to do is dash over here, get his attention, parry him, turn around, and parry this guy. Parry the world. Like I said, I would practice my parries. That way the game will be a little easier for you. Be really careful. We have a knight attacking us. This is the same knight that would have attacked us if we would have went any further up the steps here while we were fighting all those hollows. So be very, very careful. Grab ourselves a halberd. We're going to walk in, walk out. We have another knight. Parry him. These guys have a high chance of dropping titanite shards, so it can be a really easy farm if you're trying to level up certain weapons or armor. Come over here. We're gonna have a few more hollows to take care of. Woo. I love the running attack for this weapon. Because you get this spin. Oh, it's amazing. You can actually get quite a few enemies at the same time with that run and spin. It's got a wide sweep to it. Over here, we're going to have a big Balder Knight. I would back up and I would not fight him in there. I would come down over here. And fight him where you know there's not going to be any enemies. And that was really stupid of me. I see him with the backswing getting ready. Just want to wait for him to swing and then you can take a swing. No, you're not healing yourself, sir. Enemies can heal themselves, by the way, using an Estus just like you can. So keep that in mind when you're fighting. Right here we get a Titanite Shard. He always drops a Titanite Shard. Go ahead and grab this Firekeeper Soul. We'll be able to upgrade our flask here in a little bit. That'll allow us to refill more health for every Estus flask we use. Let's go down here to the Undead Parish. We're gonna light this bonfire and kindle it as well. Let's talk to Andre.
Well, I'm Andre of Astora. If you require smithing, then speak to me.
We learned his gesture. Sorry, it skipped that dialogue there. I don't know why it did that. Let's go ahead and purchase ourselves. I think we have just enough. Let's reinforce our new weapon. Our claymore. I believe we only need 9. Yes. We only need 9. We cannot modify any weapons yet. I just want to show everybody that. You can reinforce your armor, but I wouldn't, unless you're dead set on having the hard leather armor, I would not upgrade any armor right now. You can repair your equipment if you'd like. Never hurts to repair. And then we can also purchase some very useful items. We're going to purchase the weapon smith box, the armor smith box, and that'll be it. Everything else is up to you if you want to purchase. He does sell some pretty decent weapons like the bastard sword. It's just a little better than the claymore in my opinion. But I'm going to stick with the claymore. Maybe we'll use the bastard sword later on into the game to make it holy and make a certain area a little easier. We'll see. You can purchase arrows and bolts from Andre as well. And then the crest of Artorias. Oh my goodness. I cannot speak today.
Don't get yourself killed. Neither of us want to see you go hollow.
You can talk to Andre further if you like. He just explains how to smith and different types of smithing in a little more detail than what I did. So if you'd like to talk to him, have at it. I'm not going to. I know how to upgrade my weapons and whatnot. Let's Let's go back up here. We're going to kill these hollows that have respawned because we sat at the bonfire. Get ourselves a backstab. We're doing way more damage now. Over here, you can see two doorways. This is an elevator that will lead us back down to Firelink Shrine. We're not going to be heading that way just yet. For now, we're going to take care of the Bell Gargoyles. That channeler is doing a little dance. He just buffed all the enemies, made them stronger. I don't think that it buffs their defense, but I'm not sure on that. Don't quote me on it, but I know that it definitely makes them hit a lot harder. So if you're nervous, just kind of lead them back and then slowly take one out at a time. Or two out at a time, whatever you feel comfortable doing. Try to keep him from standing by the edge there. I'm gonna come over here. We have another knight over here. See if we can't parry him. Got the parry. Nice, and we got some Balder armor. Come around this side here. We're gonna roll. Roll again. And pick ourselves up some humanity. Let's roll through this door. It'll break. And up here is where we're gonna use the mystery key to let this NPC out. This is Lautrec, the douchiest NPC of them all.
Oh. Still human, are you? Then I am in luck. Could you help me? As you can see, I am stuck without recourse.
Let's open up the door for him.
Thank you. Yes, sincerely. I am Knight Lautrec of Karin. I truly appreciate this, and I guarantee a reward. Only later. Yes, very sorry. Your reward will have to wait. I've just been freed. Allow me some time.
It's really hard to hear Lautrec's voice, especially when you're at this angle. So I apologize if the audio was a little low there. Gonna backtrack a little bit here. Let's pick up this item. A large soul of a nameless soldier. And then we'll climb this ladder. Now, if you go back, rest at the bonfire, and come back through here, Lautrec's sign will be over there. You can summon him in. I'm not worried about Lautrec. I don't like him as an NPC. I don't like him as a character. We're going to worry about summoning in Solaire. Knight Solaire. Wait for him to summon in. Let him go through the fog wall, and then we're going to have a cutscene real quick. Okay, we're gonna try to cut off this gargoyle's tail. It's not always easy. Oh my goodness. There we go. We got his tail. Be very careful. We have a second gargoyle here. Solaire just killed the first one. He'd be very beneficial in this first fight. Well, in the fight in general, not the first fight, because we did kill the Taurus demon. So because Solaire survived, we get a sunlight medal, and we get twin humanities for killing two gargoyles at the same time. Right here, we'll have an NPC named Oswald. He will appear once we ring the first bell of awakening. We could probably get another level or two, but we'll save that for the next video. After we ring the bell, we'll talk to Oswald, and then we'll end the video. For now, let's go ahead and pull this lever. All right. Slide down this ladder. Slide down the next ladder. And then we have Oswald. Let's go ahead and talk to him real quick.
Greetings. I am Oswald of Kareem, the partner. Thou art a friend. For thee, a warm welcome. Cometh thou to confess, or to accuse? For indeed, all sin is my domain.
Let's go ahead and learn his gesture. He has, well, what is it? A lot of people in the PvP Dark Souls community use that. So, requesting absolution, if you accidentally hit an NPC and they went aggro towards you or are mad at you, you can request absolution and it'll use up a few of your souls, and then that NPC will no longer be mad at you. You can talk to them again and everything will be fine in the world. You can also abandon your covenants here, and then you can purchase a lot of different items from Oswald. Most importantly, you can get purging stones from him. So if you ever get cursed, you can come here, get a purging stone, and reverse the curse. You do not want to be cursed in Dark Souls 1. You also can buy Homeward Bones from him. You can buy a miracle called Karmic Justice, and a talisman, Velka's talisman to be precise. And three different rings. If you're absolutely terrified of losing all your souls, you can always come here, buy some rings of sacrifice, which I personally think is just a waste of money. You're going to spend more money buying these rings than you're going to lose in souls. So I wouldn't sweat losing souls. It's just part of playing the game, right? And obviously the blood bite ring boosts bleed resistance, and the poison bite ring boost your poison resistance. Let's go ahead and leave Oswald alone.
Thou art welcome anytime. It is only human to commit a sin.
What a sinister laugh he has. Let's go out here and end the video. Matter of fact, let's face this way. Looks prettier that way. I want to start by telling everybody thank you for stopping by and watching the video. If you enjoyed it, please hit that thumbs up button. If you didn't, hit the thumbs down button. Let me know why down in the comments below. It only helps. helps the channel. Also, if you enjoy content just like this, be sure to subscribe or don't. I don't know. I'm not your dad. Do whatever you want. And like always, everybody, have a good morning, a good afternoon, or a good night, or whatever time it may be in your part of the world. Mr. John Wayne, signing off.